Welcome back, our dear viewers, as we are celebrating the first day of the great Bayram or Eid al-Adha. Of course, it is related to meat, to fatta, to ru'a, to many heavy meals that we are consuming during the days of the Feast of Sacrifice, to shed light about what to eat and what not to eat and how to keep a healthy diet. We are very much delighted to have with us in the studio Dr. Hiba Asam, our nutritionist expert. Good day to you, Dr. Hiba, and happy feast.
Good day, happy feast to you all.
Happy feast to you, dear, and you're most welcome on RTV International. Let's start immediately with meat, as this is the occasion where all Egyptians, I think, are going to resort to meat more than anything else. Yeah. What kinds of meat we should prefer and what kinds of meat we should avoid?
Okay. First of all, it's not a feast of meat, and you have to change this thing.
No,
it's a feast of visiting our relatives and
yes, visiting,
but not eating much, and not concentrate on eating. Concentrate on any other good thing other than eating. Mm. Avoid the extra, oily meat or the fatty meat. Yes, some people also. Have their fatty meat and put a lot of butter or frying the meat also, and it's very, very dangerous thing. Yeah. So go to grilled meat, very low caloric meat or very low fatty meat. Remove the extra fat in the meat. It's very important to be a lean meat, not any fatty meat, and also the amount. We have just two pieces of meat, about 200 grams. It's very good, not more than this. Mm-hmm. Also, not eating meat alone, never to eat meat alone. You have to eat meat with salads, not alone. Yes, and not with carbohydrates. Try to eat this meat with vegetables.
Yes, that would bring me, Dr. Hiba, to ask about fatta and ru'a and the traditional food of Eid al-Adha. How many amounts we should be consuming, or the proper amount of fatta or ru'a, which we can be consuming with meat?
Okay, you can have these things, but only for one day, not the whole day of the feast, not the 4 days.
Ma'am, one day or one meal?
One meal.
One day.
One meal. One meal. Because I see a lot of people, the 4 days or maybe week, meat and fatta every day. Mm. So it's just one day, it take this, and you can consider it free meal, but not also with large amounts, adequate amount. Also, the salads and vegetables are very important. The Chinese food, must mix the meat with vegetables.
The Chinese food had nothing to do here with what we eat in Eid, unfortunately, Dr. Okay. Hiba, because the Chinese meat is shredded beef or shredded the small pieces, but in Eid, usually we eat huge portion of meat and liver and all this stuff. So we do consume beef and lamb, and what is the proper kind of meat that could be less fatty for us?
Lean meat and beef meat, less fatty than the lamb meat.
Yeah, sure.
Yes, the lamb meat is very generous in very minerals and vitamins. It's very healthy. And very healthy. But avoid for hypertensive patients, for old age patients, for people who
Even
are
small
having
pieces. If we eat lamb chops, grilled or something like that,
grilled maybe or
with
in a
salad,
in a water, for example. But not in a large amount, with very, very adequate amount. And I like to have the adequate food plate, not a large amount of carbohydrates and not a large amount of protein. No, large amount of salads, large amount of vegetables, large amount of these healthy fibers and which have
fibers,
vitamins.
Let me know more about this, ma'am, because many people would say, okay, I'm going to eat whatever I like, and then I'm going to continue with fibers or with green vegetables, and after eating this meat I'm going to drink two or three cups of green tea. And this is going to fix the whole story. Tell us about this notion and how we can change it.
Here in Egypt, people think that green tea is a magical
magic
thing.
Yeah.
And eat what you want, and then green tea or diet soda.
Yeah.
So no, it's not that.
That easy.
Yeah.
Hope it was.
Green tea is a very minimal thing that may help you in losing weight, but not like people may think. It's a very very minimal effect.
Mm-hmm.
It's a very good antioxidant. Green tea having also something helpful. Yes, but not drinking it after meal immediately.
Mm-hmm.
Just we have to wait
2 hours.
Before drinking any tea, green tea or any other tea.
Mm-hmm.
I like them to drink water. A large amount of water is very important.
When to drink water? Mm. What's the proper time to drink water? Is it before the meal, after the meal, or during the meal itself?
Before the meal. Okay,
yes.
It's very, very helpful before the meal because if you drink water before the meal, you won't feel that hungry. Yes,
mm-hmm.
It will lessen the amount of food you will
consume.
Eat. Also, if you want to drink water after a meal, after 1 hour.
Mm-hmm.
Not listen.
So it's not right to drink during eating.
No. And if you want to drink water before eating, not mm-hmm. during eating, or not immediately after the meal.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm. Another idea which you would find people following, and it's a very very mistaken.
Mm-hmm.
Citrus,
mm-hmm.
lemon,
mm-hmm.
vinegar. And there are people who think that whenever they are going to add this to their meal, this is going to lessen the fatty portions, or the fats are not going to harm us as without these things. Tell us about that, if this notion is right or wrong.
It's right. And if you add lemon or vinegar, lemon especially will get more benefit from meat. Meat contain a lot of iron. It's very very important. So if you add a lemon to the meat, it will make more benefits for this meat.
No, ma'am.
Mm.
What I'm saying?
In cooking,
a cup of water,
mm-mm.
a cup of warm water,
mm-mm.
with
not
two
for marination.
With two lemons,
mm-mm.
and I'm going to drink it first, and then whatever I'm gonna eat, mm-hmm. it's not going to be absorbed.
No, it's not true, not mm-hmm. true. Lemon is very important and very helpful, but it's not like this, like any antioxidants for this amount, no. You have also, drink lemon, it's okay, but we have to concentrate on amount of meat and the type of meat you eat.
Mm-hmm.
It's not antioxidants for this extent.
Yeah.
Dr. Hibba, what is your advice here for the people for the meal that they should be consuming during the first day of El Eid, and they should not be repeating the same after that while we are still celebrating Eid al-Adha?
Mm-hmm.
So tell us about the tips here for consuming a good meal for the first day of Eid al-Adha.
First tip, I like them to have any healthy breakfast, because I see a lot of people take their breakfast meat. No, it's very very harmful.
Mm-hmm.
Take
because it's a habit to have a meat soup.
No,
or
it's very very hard.
Grilled the liver.
Yes.
For breakfast.
No, it's very very bad for your diet, for your gastric system. So you have to have a normal breakfast. Having eggs
or
cheese,
or
yes. Also, I like them to drink plenty of water all over the day before eating meat. And then if we have the main meal or the main plate, can concentrate on salads and vegetables.
Mm-hmm.
We can eat meat and eat feta and mm-hmm. eat whatever, but having a good plate of salads,
mm-hmm.
which will lessen the harms of this meat.
Mm-hmm.
Red meat are the very very harmful source of meat or the
mm-hmm.
protein,
mm-hmm.
because it's very very helpful and very very beneficial to your body. It contains proteins
iron.
And a lot of vegetable
amino acids is for the muscles
yes.
and body.
Okay.
Those
important in growing of children
mm-hmm.
and to keep our health okay, but it's also harmful. Yani, red meat make you having more inflammation in your body, make you have a lot of disease like high
gout.
Cholesterol, yes, and gout and hypertension. Yani, it may worsen the hypertension, may lead to stroke. Yani, a lot of people who are eating a lot of meat, they have atherosclerosis, and which may lead to stroke and hemiplegia and all these bad things. So red meat, it's not a good thing. To have every day, no. Yani, listen, the amount, go to the white protein. Yani, go to fish, go to chicken. It's more helpful and less the danger, less dangers in them than the red meat.
Of course. Dr. Heba, I insist on seizing the opportunity whenever you are here to fix or to change all the habits Egyptians are now following, thinking that this is the best way to avoid the harm effects of fat, but with eating fat. We spoke about a cup with just squeezing two lemons or something. Mm-mm. But let's go to yogurt with lemon. Mm-hmm. Yogurt with lemon before going to sleep. Mm-hmm. This is going to fix the whole, all
the
what
magic.
I've done in the morning or all over the day. Tell us about this and whether it's gonna do something nice, or at least how we can do that, especially that, for example, there are people who are suffering acidity, but they insist on doing that despite the fact that this can be very harmful.
Yes.
Tell us.
Here in Egypt, people want to a magical thing that will make you them slim without any
effort.
So they want to eat what they want all over the day, high amount of calories, high amount of sweets, and all the bad things, but not gaining any weight. Mm-hmm. So they are waiting this magic. No, there's no magic. Till now, there's no magic that will transform you to a very metabolic state. No. So you have to change your behavior, to change your lifestyle. And eating is a lifestyle. If you have... or making diets and lose a lot of weight. So if we stop this and back to the bad habits, you will gain this weight again. Mm-hmm. So I like to change the mind, change the knowledge. You have to know
mindset.
What to eat, yes, and what not to eat. All over the years, all over the age of any people, just any culture. You have to change the culture.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So you have to eat the healthy food. You have to love the healthy food, not to making this like a drug, or a bad thing. No, love the vegetable, love the fruits, love the healthy eating, love drinking water, a large amount of water.
Yes, that would bring me to ask about drinking water, because some of us, they just forget to drink water.
Mm-mm.
So how we should train ourselves to consume better amount of
water. Knowing the benefits of water is important. If you know how benefits of water, it's it will change the mind of the people. If they don't love the taste of water, you can add something like lemon. If you want to change the taste of water,
lemon.
Also fluids. I don't want just water. They may have fluids. Fluids like
fresh juices.
Yes, juices, but natural juices without adding.
Sugar.
Adding sugars, or like green tea, like cinnamon, like any
ginger,
drink.
Whatever.
Yes,
but inshallah we are gonna enjoy Eid. And by the way, this is the way people enjoy Eid all over the world. In Thanksgiving,
so
we eat turkey, they eat turkey,
to eat,
and
today.
In Halloween they eat a lot of candies and sweets. So we are no exception. But we are going to enjoy it, but in a moderate way.
Yes.
Dr. Heba Assam, our nutritionist, thank you very much for being with us today, and happy Eid.
Thank you. Happy Eid.
Happy.
And by this, we come to the end of our breakfast show today. Before we go, happy Eid once again to all our viewers. You are in the company of my dear colleague, Mahisti Rabia, and myself, Nermeen Abdelrahman. Always a pleasure to be with you on
Always a pleasure, Nermeen. Happy Eid to you, and happy Eid to all our dear viewers. Till tomorrow with another crew. It's goodbye and happy feast.